When Nick and I created Scientists in the Field, what we were looking for was to be writing not just about some animal, a bunch of facts about it. We wanted to provide some real drama. We wanted to take kids on a real exciting, real-life expedition, and our books have a narrative. And there wasn't a whole lot out there. Not only do we have a narrative, but we have these great heroes and heroines in our narratives who I think are great role models for kids, because scientists, a lot of people who are working in science in the field today, didn't even like science when they were growing up because they thought it was a big book of answers you had to memorize and not a process, not an adventure, not exploring. But that's what it is. And in the field, as a scientist, you're really using so much more than science too, aren't you? I mean, you're MacGyvering in the field. You're using everything you ever learned. I mean, for me, to do these books, I've had to use my physical fitness skills. I've had to swim for hours. I've had to ride camels and horses and elephants. I've had to learn foreign languages. And it really helps to know one foreign language. And boy, even if you don't learn the whole language, just being able to say hello in Bengali or Mongolian or talk Pisan really makes people happy to see you. All the stuff I learned as a Girl Scout, I've used in researching these books. And scientists need that. I think field science or writing about field scientists is just one of the most fun and exciting and demanding and thrilling jobs you could ever have. And I feel like I'm the luckiest person on earth. I always go to the library first thing. I mean, of course, I read all that I can about Mongolia if I'm going to write about snow leopards, or New Guinea if I'm writing about tree kangaroos, or Bengali culture if I'm going to go to West Bengal. And so the research really does start in the library. And I try to see any films about my subject. But a lot of what we do in Scientists in the Field series is the science is unfolding in front of you. You couldn't get it in a book. So the story is really happening in front of you. And what you want to do is go to the field with your heart full of all the background you can get. But you also want to be very receptive to all this very new stuff that is going to happen in front of you, maybe for the first time ever anywhere. And it invariably does, because the universe is just so full of gifts for us. And the teachers are going to come out of the woodwork and show us the way.